Good morning, my dear students. A very warm welcome to you all. Today, we are going to start with indefinite pronouns. Let us see what are indefinite pronouns. So, the words like somewhere, anywhere, everywhere, and many more, these are all indefinite pronouns. We'll see these examples. So indefinite pronouns, they may refer to things, places or people. Now the indefinite pronouns which refers to things are something, anything and nothing. The indefinite pronouns that refers to places, somewhere, anywhere, nowhere. And the indefinite pronouns that refers to people, someone or somebody, anyone or anybody, no one or nobody. So these all are indefinite pronouns. Let's move ahead. Now see here, we use something, somewhere, someone and somebody in affirmative sentences. Already you have learned what is affirmative sentence, right? For example, there is something in the closet. There is something in the closet. Now this is affirmative sentence, and something, it is used to show the thing. So something is kept in the closet. Your keys are somewhere in the room. Somewhere denotes the place. Your keys are somewhere in the room. There is someone on somebody at the door. It refers to person. There is someone or somebody. Means we don't know what is the thing. We don't know the place where the key is kept. We don't know who the person is at the door. So we use these words. These are indefinite. So we use indefinite pronouns. Let's move ahead. We use anything, anywhere, anyone, anybody in question and negative sentences. Now anything, anywhere, anyone or anybody. These are used in questions and negative sentences. Something, someone, somebody, somewhere we use in affirmative sentences, while anything, anywhere, anyone, anybody is used in questions or negative sentences. For example, is there anything in that fridge? So this is a question. There isn't anything in that fridge. Now here this is negative sentence because is not is used here. Did you go anywhere yesterday? This is a question again. I did not go anywhere last night. This is negative sentence. Is there anyone in the room 23? This is a question. There isn't anyone at the reception desk. So anything is used to refer thing. Anywhere is used to refer place, and anyone is used to refer people. Okay. Let's move ahead. We use nothing, nowhere, no one or nobody when we want to convey a negative meaning. So when we want to convey a negative meaning, so at that time we use nothing, nowhere, no one or nobody. Now the sentence here will be affirmative, but the meaning is always negative. Even though sentence is affirmative, the meaning is negative. For example, there is nothing to eat. So nothing, this is indefinite pronoun which refers thing. There is nowhere to go in this town. Now nowhere refers place. There is no one or nobody at the reception desk. Here people. Let us see examples. Would you like to eat some cake? Now this is a question. No thanks, I can eat dash after 8. No thanks, I can eat dash after 8. So I can eat nothing. I can eat nothing after 8. Next, I'm so hungry, I need dash to eat. I'm so hungry, I need something to eat. This is affirmative sentence. Next example, let's go to the beach, shall we? Oh no, I'm so tired, I don't want to go. Now we are referring to place. So I don't want to go. Now this is a negative sentence. So we'll use anywhere. I don't want to go anywhere. Next. There are 28 people here and only 27 chairs. There is dash for me to sit. There is nowhere for me to sit. Now this is a place. Nowhere. Next. The house is so quiet, I think there is dash here. Now, as the house is quiet, there is no one here. Okay. Next. I am so hungry. Is there dash to eat? Now, this is a question. So, in question, what do we use? Anything, right? So, here now, in option 2 and 3, in both these options, the first answer is anything. Let's read the further sentence. I'm sorry, but there is dash to eat. But there is something to eat or nothing to eat? There is nothing to eat. Option C is correct. We'll move towards reciprocal pronouns. Already you have learnt the meaning of reciprocal in maths, right? So today we are going to see the reciprocal pronouns. So what are reciprocal pronouns? Pronouns which means that an action or activity that occurs involving two people or groups. So the activity which involves two people or groups who do the same against each other. So two people or two groups who do the same thing against each other. For that we use reciprocal pronouns. We use reciprocal pronouns when each of two or more subjects in acting in the same way towards the other. So when do we use reciprocal pronoun? When each of the two or more subjects, so both the subjects or more subjects, they are acting in the same way towards each other. So both the subjects or more than two subjects are doing the same thing against each other or towards each other. Now let us see kinds of reciprocal pronouns. So there are two, each other, and one, another. So these are reciprocal pronouns. Now let us see. They enable us to simplify sentences where the same general idea is expressed two or more times. Now, when do we use reciprocal, or why do we use reciprocal pronouns? Because they enable us to simplify sentences. The sentence doesn't remain complicated. These reciprocal pronouns, they simplify the sentences where the same general idea is expressed two or more times. So when the same idea is expressed for two or more times, then for that purpose we use reciprocal pronouns. Let's move ahead. Example. At the birthday party, Nuggy gave Furley a candy and Furley gave Nuggy a candy. Now see here, at birthday party what happened? Nagi gave Furly a candy and Furly gave Nagi a candy. Now Nagi and Furly, these are the two subjects and they are doing the same thing to each other. So in such time, now see here, we have repeated gave a candy. These words are repeated in both in these sentences. So to avoid this, we use reciprocal pronouns. So the same sentence can be written as, at the birthday party Nagi and Furly gave each other a candy. So now gave candy is written only once, not twice like in this sentence, isn't it? So to avoid this, to simplify the sentence, we use reciprocal pronouns. Next, if we need to refer to more than two people or things, we could use the reciprocal pronoun one another. Now each other is used for two people, but if you want to refer to more than two people or things, then we use one another. Okay, more than two, we use one another. For example, the students in the classroom cooperate with one another. Now students, there are more than two students, so we have used one another. The four boys help one another with their work. Again, one another, because boys are four, there are more than two. So if there are only two subjects or two groups, then we use each other. If there are more than two, then we use one another. Next, each other is used in more examples than one another. Mostly we use each other more as compared to one another, because in general we use each other more often than one another, which sounds a little formal. Now each other sounds little formal, so we use each other more often than one another. Okay, next, there must be two or more people or group. Now what we have learned, that there must be two or more people or group. Subjects must be doing same thing. So if subjects are not doing same thing, we can't use reciprocal pronouns. So subject must be doing the same things. The action is reciprocated. And one another is used for more than two subjects. So these are the things which we have learnt in reciprocal pronoun. We are going to learn relative pronouns. Which are the relative pronouns? Who, whom, which, that, whose, and where. These are relative pronouns. These are all relative pronouns. Okay. Now, who is used as the subject of the clause. Now, already you have learned what is a clause. A clause is a group of words which has a subject and a verb, right? Let us see the example. The woman who called you is here. Now, who called you is here. Now, this is a clause. So we can write the same sentence like, the woman is here, she called you. Now here who means who? The woman. So that is she. So it acts as the subject of the clause. Next, whom is used as the object of the clause. The woman whom you called is here. Okay, now here see this sentence. The woman is here. You called her. Now whom, it represents her, means this woman. So it acts as a object of the clause. So you can also omit the object pronouns. You can say the woman you called is here. So you can also write the same. You can also omit this object pronoun and you can write the woman you called is here. Okay, so this way also you can write the sentence. Let's move ahead. The use of that and which, they are used as the subject of the clause. The phone is here, it is red. Now it means what? The phone. So in place of it, we have used the relative pronoun that. The phone that is red is here. Or the phone which is red is here. So here also which represents it, right? So remember that can also refer to a person. Now that, it can also be used for a person. So it is used for both thing and person. That is used for thing as well as person, which is only used for thing. It is not used for person. So which cannot be used to refer person. That much you have to keep in mind. Let's move ahead. Now you have seen that and which used as the subject. Now we'll see that and which used as an object of the clause. The phone is here, you brought it. Now it is object. So in place of it, we have used the pronoun that. We have used the relative pronoun that. So the phone that you brought is here. So here that is used as object of the clause. Or you can also use which, because phone is a thing. So for thing you can either use that or you can use which. Anyone you can use. The phone which you brought is here. Okay. Also you can omit the object in this sentence. You can say the phone you brought is here. Okay, so you can omit that or which. So object pronoun is not compulsory, you can omit it. Okay, next. Now the common errors or common mistakes which are made. The telephone is here, that is yours. So here this sentence is wrong. Why? So the telephone that is yours is here. So this words should come at the end. The man which you are talking about isn't a friend. Now which cannot be used with person. For person you can use that. Or you can use who, but not which. So this both sentences are wrong. Omitting an object pronouns. Now you can omit the object pronouns but not subject pronouns. Subject pronouns cannot be omitted. The woman who called you is here. Now here, she called you. She is a subject pronoun. So you cannot omit. You cannot say the woman called you is here. That will be wrong. So subject pronoun cannot be omitted. The phone that is red is here. Phone is here. It is red. So it is used as a subject. So instead of that, we have used the relative pronoun that. So this is also a subject pronoun. so it cannot be omitted. The phone which is red is here. So you can use that or which for things, as I told you earlier, right? Next, the man whom you want to speak to has just left. Object pronoun. So the man you want to speak has just left. You can use this way also. Your father, whom you look like, was a great friend of mine. Your father, whom you look like, was a great friend of mine. The little boy who brings the milk hasn't been for these days. Take nothing that is not necessary. So these are subject pronouns, cannot be omitted. So now what does relative pronoun do? They refer back to the noun or pronoun mentioned before. My sister, who is from Chicago, visited me last weekend. So who here means who? My sister. So it refers back to the noun or pronoun. So you can write without commas and you can write with commas also. I hope you have understood relative pronouns. So today we have completed the topic pronouns. I hope you have understood it. Thank you.